to have the water moving and the mass flow moving those nutrients towards the plants. And so you can get more water that can stay in the soil environment and keep that soil environment moist. At the same time, by having better coverage of the soil surface, you don't get as much evapotranspiration, or you don't get as much evaporation out of the soil itself. So you don't lose that moisture that you want to be able to retain. And again, under climatic uncertainty, we need to get the water in, and we need to keep that water there. And that's what we're trying to do, is look at being able to do those things. So as we know, our current agricultural system is very resource intensive, and that's continuing to increase. What we have in our systems is we have systems that are, this was some work that was done by David Tillman, and basically what it shows is that we have very inefficient use of our nutrients. Our nitrogen fertilizer use, our synthetic nitrogen fertilizer use efficiency is somewhere about 30 to 50%, which means that that's all that gets into the plant. If you were to go and buy a product that you only got 30 to 50% efficiency out of, you would go back to the store and say, give me my money back. You owe me at least 50% off on this.
So, you, poor man, get to have the conventional soil. Sorry, you reject it, all right? You're gonna have the biodynamic soil. All right. You're gonna have organic soil. These soils are all from France. We bring soils into the U.S., from the U.S. into France. We want to do that. All right, so, and I need one more volunteer. All right. So this has, these bottles have the same amount of water. The cup with the soil in it has holes in the bottom. So if you want to hold it up and hold it over the other cup, we're going to look to see how fast the water is going to drip out of there. So the ones of us who have bottles of water, we're going to all pour about the same time over the top of the cup. And let's see how fast this works. So everybody go. Pour the whole thing. So you can hold it up and you can see it's starting to drip in the organic soil. It's not dripping in the conventional soil, and it's dripping in the biodynamic soil. So we're looking at water infiltration rates here, still sitting there in the conventional soil. So how fast can the water get into the soil? The other thing that we can take a look at is how much water is going to be held. So if you had a completely flat field in a few hours, you could probably sit here and hold this and wait until the water stays in there. But if it's not a completely flat field, that water is going to run off the surface, and what's going to carry with it? It's going to carry with it synthetic nutrients, and it's going to carry with it topsoil. Now, for these other organic soils from the biodynamic farm and from the organic farm here in France, the other thing that happens is I added 50 mils of water, and then add 50 mils of water to each of these soils. And I'm going to take a look here. Your biodynamic farm. Very little water that's left here, less than, I would say, less than about 20 mils is in here. This one has about 30 mils. So you've got more water holding capacity that you've got in these systems. And it's the biology that helps to do this. It's the biology that helps to form this. Somebody can make this poor man stand here and hold this for any longer. So thank you to my volunteers.